increase is given and increase is asked. Formula is R by 100 minus R into 100. R by 100 minus R into 100. Usually what we do is, for this problem we will take this formula, for previous problem we take this formula. Confusion will be there. Remember one thing, increase is given means plus, decrease is given means minus. In that way you have to remember. Okay. Next. Previously when I used to teach, I used to teach happily without any tension. This time they are recording. Whatever I talk, it will be recorded. So I should be in full conscious and I should take care of myself. Is it not? That is the problem. I don't know this recording program why they have. Okay. No problem. Anyhow, I got an opportunity to act before a camera. This is my first film. And after this, my rates will be increased. I may go to Hollywood. Then you may not get a chance to meet me. Okay, we will spend 2 days. Next problem. If each side of a square is increased by 50%. If each side of a square is increased by 50%, then what is the percentage increase in its perimeter? If each side of a square is increased by 50%, then what is the percentage increase in its perimeter? See here, we don't know anything about a square. Take any square of considerable length. Say for example, each side has 10 units. If I take a square each side of 10 units, what is the perimeter of the square? 40 units. What is the perimeter of the square? 40 units. Each side is increased by 50%. Each side has become how much? 15. So this is 15, this is 15, means what is the perimeter of this? 16. 40 perimeter has become 60. Implies for 40 there is an increase of 20. For 100, what would be the increase? Compared with 40, the value of 100 will be more. So more by less into 20. 22s to 50s. So 50%. But here, as far as my knowledge is concerned, there won't be any change in the perimeters. Sides are increased by 10%, perimeter will increase by 10%. Sides are decreased by 15%, perimeter will decrease by 15%. Not only for squares, rectangle, triangle, trapezium, rhombus, parallelogram, whatever it may be, there will not be any change in the perimeter. That is the reason they don't ask this question in the campus recruitment. Understand? But why I have taken this problem is, areas, that is important. In areas they will ask, right? Next question, write down. If each side of a square, if each side of a square is increased by 50% if each side of a square is increased by 50%, then what is the percentage increase? Then what is the percentage increase in its area? Area. Again, let us assume that each side of a square has 10 units. Each side of a square has 10 units. What is the area here? 100 square units. Each side is increased by 50%. What is each side? 15, 15. What is the area? 225. 100 square units area has become 225 means for 100 what would be the increase? So area percentage increase in the area is 125%. Here also you see, whatever may be the diagram, whether it is a square, a rectangle, circle, whatever it may be, and whatever may be the data that is given in the question. Suppose I take squares. What is the possibility of asking the question? If each side of a square is increased by 50%, what is the percentage increase in the area? If the perimeter of a square is increased by 50%, what is the percentage increase in the area? If the length of the diagonal is increased by 50%, what is the percentage increase in the area? What are the other possibilities? No. Whatever may be the diagram, whatever may be the data that is given in the problem, percentage increase in the area is equal to 2x plus x square by 100. Percentage increase in the area is 2x plus x square by 100. Because in certain problems we cannot assume the value like this. Suppose if I take a circle, suppose if I take a nominal circle 7, because it has to be cancelled by pi, 22 by 7. Increased by 10% means again if I take 10% on 7 or 15% on 7, it may or may not be cancelled with 7. Again calculation will become bigger. In such cases formula is best. Right? Next. If the perimeter of a square, I have taken the standard diagram as square, but this is applicable to all the diagrams, okay? If the perimeter of a square is decreased by 50%, if the perimeter of a square is decreased by 50%, then what is the percentage decrease? Then what is the percentage decrease in its area? Perimeter is decreased by 50% implies sides are decreased by 50%, is it not? Each side assumed as 10 units, the area is 100. Each side is decreased by 50% means each side has become 5 units. The area is 25. 100 area has become 25 means for 100 there is a decrease of 75. So 75% decrease. 75% decrease. Otherwise, the percentage decrease in the area means what is the formula? 2x minus x square by 100. Percentage decrease in the area is equal to 2x minus x square by 100. Percentage decrease. If only one value is given, that formula will apply. Even if I say length of a rectangle increased by 10%, breadth is decreased by 5%, the value differs. For that, no, you should not take. If the length and breadth of a rectangle are increased by 20%, it is applicable. Yes, different formula. For same value, you have to take like this. Okay. Next, the salary of a person, the salary of a person is first increased by 50%. The salary of a person is first increased by 50% and then the increased salary is decreased by 50%. What is the overall effect? What is the overall effect in his salary? The salary of a person is first increased by 50% and again the increased salary is decreased by 50%. What is the overall effect in his salary? See here, whenever increase and decrease percent values are same, and whatever may be the order, he may ask first increase and then decrease, or he may give first decrease and then increase, whatever it may be, if both increase and decrease values are equal, the result is always decrease. What we call it as minus R square method. Minus R square by 100, minus always represents decrease. So, the salary is first increased by 50% and then decreased by 50%. So, 50 into 50 by 100 means 25% decrease. Without solving the problem, you can write. What is the overall effect means? Totally, salary will be decreased by 25%. If you want to solve the problem, let us assume that the original salary of a person is 100. The salary is first increased by 50% means it has become 150. Again decreased by 50% means 50% of 150 is 75. 75 decreased means 75. 100 salary has become 75 means 25% decreased. For equal values, you need not solve the problem. For unequal values, you have to go with this method. For unequal values, you will have to go with this method. Right? Write down that model also. a discount of 20% is offered. A discount of 20% is offered on all goods by a shopkeeper, and as a result, his sales are increased by 30%. And as a result, his sales are increased by 30%. Find the overall effect. Find the overall effect on his daily receipts. Daily receipts. For this, 20 into 30 by 100, if you write, 6% decrease, if you can say, that is wrong. That is wrong. Different values means go with the calculation. Suppose a shopkeeper is selling for 100 rupees a day. By closing, he will sell for 100 rupees. Suppose he offers a discount of 20% means 100 rupees sale will come down to 80. But because he is giving the reduction, the sales are increased by what percent? 30%. 30% on what? Whoever comes to the shop is paying 100 rupees or 80 rupees. So 30% will increase on 80 rupees. In 80 rupees, 10% is 8 rupees. 30% is 24 rupees. 80 plus 24 is 104. 100 collection has become 104 means 4% increase. 4% increase. So, 4% increase. So, equal values only we take directly. Otherwise, unequal values, you have to go with the procedure. Right? Next. When 75% of a number, when 75% of a number is added, to 75, when 75% of a number is added to 75, the result is the number itself. The result is the number itself. What is the number? When 75% of a number is added to 75, the result is the number itself. What is the number? All of your procedure is, let the number be X. 75% of X is added to 75, the result is X. But we people, when we do aptitude, we avoid X. Our thinking is, I'll show you the difference, what way we are going. 75% of a number is added to 75. The result is the number itself means 75% of a number is added to 75. The result is 100% of the number, is it not? 100%. 75% is added to 25% only, the 100% will come, is it not? So 25% is equal to 75. Then 100% will be equal to how much? said, this is our concept. Just for concept's sake, I'm telling this problem. So compared with 25%, 100% will be more. More by less into 75, 25 threes, 300. Usually explanation I have given more. Usually 25 three times, 100 will become three times. Here only it is say 25 three times, 100 will become three times. So this all varies in a method. What you have to do is you have to concentrate on the methods. Methodology differs. Shortcut method means, I'll tell you how the shortcut method will be. There won't be shortcut methods directly. Each for this problem, this is the method. This problem, no. By seeing the method problem, you have to decide. Suppose if I ask, what is 43 minus 19? No immediate answer, because this is a bigger problem. 3 minus 9 will not go. Borrow 1 from the 13 minus 9. Suppose if I ask, what is 44 minus 20? 24 is seen in the problem itself. Whenever you see this problem, it should appear to your eyes like this. What the method I have taken here means, subtract whatever value I have to subtract, I will make it nearer to 0. For 19 I have added 1. When for minus value I had 1, plus value also I should add 1. So that the problem is balanced. So 44 minus 20 will be 24. So shortcut method means, this is the shortcut method. And only multiplication, if you want to learn, you can learn for 2 months. There are so many methods. Division, if you want to learn, you can learn for 10 minutes. I think we are ace barred for these methods. If these methods are taught in schooling, by the time you come to the college, it will be different. But this now it is too late. But why I am telling is, even after marriage, you see that your children will get all these benefits. Vedic mathematics is available. And nowadays, Vedic mathematics workbooks are also available. Understand? And those are some foreign authors of the Treschenberg speed system of mathematics. Russian author is there. Treschenberg. I think you might have seen. Treschenberg, that man hates multiplication. He want to do all the multiplication in the form of addition. Sometime he was put in a jail for 3 or 4 years. So in that 4 years in the jail, what he did is, he has developed all the additions to the multiplication. Suppose, one simple example, 432 multiplied with 11. Usually what we do, we multiply. First you multiply with then 1 and then again with 1 and we'll add. So 11 directly we multiply. That fellow will do, he'll put a 0 here. He'll put a 0 here. Addition. 2 plus next number 2, 3 plus 2 is 5, 4 plus 3 is 7, 0 plus 4 is 4. This is multiplication with 11. That is multiplication with 11. 42 multiplied with 24, 4 2 is 8, 16 plus 4, 20 is 0, 4 2 is 8 plus 2 10. This is the answer, 2 digit, 5 seconds. To check out whether it is right or wrong, the sum of the digits in the problem should be equal to sum of the digits in the answer. 4 plus 2, 6 into 2 plus 4, 6. Okay. 4 plus 2, 6. 2 plus 4, 6. 6, 6 is a? 3 plus 6? 9. 1 plus 0 plus 0 plus 8 is how much? 9. Suppose in case if you get 1 extra here or 7 here, the addition will not be tallied. So in that way, in addition, multiplication is also developed. So whenever you find time, you see this. And in campus recruitment days, Shakuntala Devi puzzles book is also very, very important. Shakuntala Devi puzzles book is also very, very important. So many times I saw at least one or two questions from her book. So that book is very cheap, 50 or 60 rupees. Instead of buying 1-2 liter thumbs up bottle, you buy Shakuntala Devi puzzles. That will be useful. Right? Next problem. In an examination, 70% of the students passed in history. In an examination, 70% of the students passed in history. 72% in geography. 10% are failed in both the subjects, and if 10% are failed in both the subjects, find the pass percentage. Find the pass percentage. In an examination, 70% of the students passed in history, 72% in geography, and if 10% are failed in both the subjects, find the pass percentage. See here. Whenever in the examination, he will give two values this, one value is failed. You fill up the total box here, 70% are passed in history means how many failed in 30, 28, 10% failed means how much passed, 90%. And this problem can be solved through Venn diagram, is it not? I will write Venn diagram for the failed candidates because the number is less. History, failures are 30%. In history, there are two types of students who failed. One is only history. The other is bonus geography also. In history and geography, already 10% are there. So only history is how many? 20. Put together, 30% failed in history. Similarly, in geography, 28% means already 10% are there with history. Only geography, 18. So if he fails in one paper or two papers, fail is fail. 20 plus 10, 30 plus 18, 48% is the fail person. 48% is the fail person means what is the pass person? 52%. Otherwise, in examination, if you want to write down directly the pass percent is equal to pass plus pass minus pass. This is nothing but n of a plus n of b is equal to n of a union b plus n of a intersection b. That I told in simplest way. Pass plus pass means individual subjects. Minus pass means two subjects together. Okay. So, 70 plus 72, 142 minus 90 is 52. Otherwise, always remember you have to convert. Otherwise, fail percent is equal to fail plus fail minus fail. Pass percent is equal to pass plus pass minus pass. Fail percent is equal to fail plus fail minus fail. If you want to find a fail percent also, you can do this. Next. Next problem. was planted a palm tree was planted 2 years ago. A palm tree was planted 2 years ago. It increases at the rate of 20% every year. Now the height of the tree is 540 centimeters. Now the height of the tree is 540 centimeters. What it was when the tree was planted? What it was when the tree was planted? Now, with these 2-3 problems, you will understand concept of person, how we are doing. Usually, the unknown data we assume to be X, is it not? Here, the palm tree which was planted 2 years, let us assume that the height of 100 centimeters. It increases at the rate of 20% every year means, first year 20% increased means how much it becomes? 120. Second year again 20% increased means how much? Now the 20% increase will be on 120. In 120, 10% is 12 and 20% is 24. This is the height of the tree 2 years ago. This is present height. Now the height of the tree is 540 centimeters means 144 will be equal to 540 centimeters, is it not? What it was when the tree was planted means 100 will be equal to how much? So 144 is equal to 540 centimeters and 100 will be equal to how much? It will be lesser, is it not? So less by more into 540. 18 8s, 18 30s, 4 2s, 4 25s, 2 15s. 25 into 15 is 375 centimeters. This 25 into 15, there is a shortcut method. 5 5s are 25, but I'll put 75. Which is the higher value in this? 2. 2 square is 4. 4 minus 1. N square minus 1. 375. 75 into 85 means 5 5 is 75. 8 square is 64 minus 3 is 63. Like that we take. So, this is the way calculating the percentages. Next problem is given in the campus report. Write down. Whenever I feel bored, I have a remedy. I always keep my wife's photograph in the pocket. Really? Whenever I feel bore, I'll take out and just see. Compared with this bore, other things are not at all boring in the life. Not at all boring in the life. Put again. Sometimes you may feel sorrow, unhappy, uneasiness. Take out. Compared with this unhappy, this uneasiness, Nothing is uneasy in the life. But when you are in happy moods, don't take out this. That is the remedy. Okay. So those who are married, always carry your wife's photo. That will help you a lot. Okay. Next. You want to carry 2-3 photographs, sir? I'm telling this for future. In India, what happens is whether you get a job or not, definitely you'll be married. Marriage is the ultimate. Even if you don't get the job, you don't have proper income also, marriage will certain. So definitely it will happen. So I'm telling all the remedies. Before I go with these students, I'll tell you some remedies to live happy with wife. Happily living with wife. No meaning for happy, is it not? Next problem. If the numerator of a fraction, if the numerator of a fraction be increased by 15% and the denominator be diminished by 8%. Then the value of the fraction is 15/16. Then the value of the fraction is 15/16. What is the original fraction? What is the original fraction? If the numerator of a fraction be increased by 15% and the denominator be diminished by 8%, then the value of the fraction is 15/16. What is the original fraction? A regular question. We don't know anything. A fraction means the idea is a numerator and a denominator. A by B. If you are not disturbing A by B, 100% of A is present here and 100% of B is present here. But what we are doing, numerator is increased by 15%. I am not putting percent mean here because percent will get cancelled. Denominator will be diminished by 8%. The value of the fraction be 15/16. Find the original fraction means you'll have to find A by B. 5 threes, 5 23s, 23 fours, 4 fours. A by B is equal to 3/4. The original fraction is 3/4. The original fraction will become 3/4. Last problem. If you say the answer correctly, we will go to the next topic after the break. Otherwise, we will continue the percentages before the break. Okay. A woman spends 75% of her income Her income is increased by Her income is increased by 20%. And she increased her expenses by 10%. Her income is increased by 20% and she increased her expenses by 10%. Find the percentage savings, percentage increase in her savings. Find the percentage increase in her savings. How much? 5.5. No. Find the percentage increase in her savings. No. Percent is right. Say for example, the salary of the woman, income of the woman is 100. A woman spends 75% of her income. In 100 she will spend 75. Means how much she is saving? 25. Her income is increased by 20%. How much? 120. She increased her expenses by 10%. Don't put 85. Previously her expenditure was 75. She increased 10% means 10% of 75 increased. 7.5. 82? 0.5. How much now she is saving? 37.5. For an increase of 25, previously she used to save 25, now she is saving 37.5. For every 25 rupees, 12.5 rupees is increased. For every 25 rupees, how much is increase? 12.5. For 100, what would be the increase? It will be more. More by less into 12.5. 12.5 twos, 250s. So our income is increased by 50%. Clear? So after the break we go with profit, loss and discount. So profit, loss and discount.